the moon.
Hey guys, Mr. Saving the Day. We're starting off the trail hike here to Maroon Bells. We're near Aspen area. I've got everything recorded in my Suunto, and I'm going to start right here at the lake, and you can check it out on mysuunto.com. But here we go. Let's go up there. All right, guys, here we are. This is a hike up Maroon Bells. We left early. We stayed just south of Glenwood Springs on a road called 4 Mile Road at an Airbnb there. Fantastic little place. And so it took us an hour to get down here, but we got up early. We got up at 5. And it's 7:45 right now on a Wednesday. And we were able to find there was plenty of parking spots. We were worried, because all the reviews on all trails and everything about not finding parking spots and shuttle buses and everything else, but we did good. And here we are. And we basically have a empty trail other than a couple people and some families. I am really excited about it. Very cool. It's surprising for how much use that this trail gets. It's just wider than the single track. You'd think as much visitors as this place sees, the path would be a lot wider. It's not gravelly, it's pretty, just big rocks. Hey guys, we are, according to the Suunto, 0.63 miles in from the pond. And now we've got a little bit of elevation. It starts going up here a little bit now, guys. It was just a meandering, slowly go upgrade. Now it's going up just a little bit more. Start losing my breath, of course. Northeast Ohio compared to a Colorado. High elevation person anyway. So I'm going to shut the camera off. Roll some GoPro film in for you. But through the aspens, we're looking at the mountains. Absolutely beautiful.
Look at that.
Hey guys, Mr. Saving the Day. We are 0.83, so a little bit further into the trail here, and you get to this rock field. with the aspens and a great view of the mountain. And absolutely awesome morning. We've passed, just a couple guys passed us, young guys. But you don't hear anybody. It's nice. Alright guys, we just did a little switchback here. And we're at 1.1 miles. A little bit uphill. Just have to make sure I take my deep breaths. But it's absolutely beautiful, quiet. We've passed a lot of people actually coming down. I think a lot of people get here early and watch the sunrise, which is kind of cool. So we've actually had a couple guys pass us, and we've probably passed three couples coming down the mountain this early. So anyway, awesome. Good views coming up here, guys. As we break through the woods, hey, Mr. Saving the Day.
Hey.
You enjoying this?
Oh my God.
I hope you guys, through the fisheye lens of a GoPro, can at least try to take in the view here. Get an idea of the aspect. The ratio is just probably hard to see what we're looking at. It's incredible. Blue skies, snow on the mountain, pine trees. We're 1.19 miles in. That is from the first lake there, Maroon Lake. Not the parking lot. Come with me as we hike over this rise. Hey guys, we're 1.47 miles in, and some crazy tree breaks here. It's I guess it would be avalanche. Aspens are all broke off, probably about 3 foot, 4 foot, some 6 foot. Nah. The only thing I can figure is maybe avalanche from up there. Ripped them down. You see where they've come in and sawed some of them, get them out of the way. But the power of the snow, if that's what it is, that's just incredible. Yeah. Yeah, guys. We are firm believer that poles pay for themselves. This is carbon fiber cascade mountain technology. They're a three-piece pole, so they come apart in three pieces, easy to travel with. They come with all the different ends on them. We use a rubber footprint type so we don't damage the areas we're in with the it's carbide tipped. If you take that off, we don't want to scratch the rocks up in the ground and poke holes and stuff we don't need to be poking holes in. We use the poles basically just for stability. We find that it takes a little less use of muscles and in your lower body, in your legs, your knees, trying to correct your position and keep yourself nice and stable and straight. Just use the poles as a guide. Every once in a while you'll feel yourself put weight on them. That's weight you're not putting on your knees and ankles. This is so incredible, you guys. I hope each and every one of you get a chance and are blessed enough to be able to get out here and do this, especially to take your family and kids. A challenge to my kids, get your kids out someday and do this. We've instilled the values of the outdoors in our kids, and it's paid off 100 times over. To appreciate nature and the value in it and knowing it's here. Maybe even if you don't get the chance to walk this path, you can watch the video. And know that places like this exist. All right, guys, we are almost there. We're at 1.67 miles, and the sign said 1.4. from the last cutoff that we were at, so I imagine it's just up here to our left. All right, guys, I think we're walking right up here on Crater Lake. Just a second. Oh my. It's not very deep, I mean. Now look at all of them. There's like 8 of them. Hey guys, we are kind of extending. Hold on a second here. Gotta hold the camera right. we're kind of extending our hike. We went past Crater Lake now. We are at 2.32 miles out, and it's just too beautiful to stop hiking. We're on vacation. We have no hurry to be anywhere. If we don't make it up to Hanging Lake, we don't make it up to Hanging Lake today. But it's just too beautiful to stop hiking. This is looking back at Crater Lake from where we are now on the trail. Alright guys, we're 2.69 miles from the beginning. Been hiking for about an hour 46, although we've done a lot of sightseeing along the way. A lot. Yeah.
One, two, three.
Hey guys, Mr. Saving the Day. We are 3.54 miles up basically from the start of the parking lot there at Maroon Bells. We've actually come up to a point now. We've hit a little snowpack still up here and stream. Very cool. This is Saving the Day. Stay there. Almost over your boot, that last one. It went right to the top of it. Hey guys, we are hiking in snow now. Check it out. August 21st. Three and a half miles in. Alright guys, here we are. It's the end of the trail for today for us. If you keep going further up this West Maroon Belt Trails, you see that ridge line right there in front of you? Basically, you're going to cross over top of it and be able to look into the next valley and this valley. But we just do not have the time today to do that. We weren't even prepared to be going as far as we are today. But we're going to take a break right here in this little valley. Alright guys, Mr. Saving the Day, I'm going to cut it off from here. You guys have seen the whole hike. I probably talked more than I should have. We're at 4.37 miles. It's 11 a.m. We've been hiking for 3 hours. And
not at any kind of fast
pace. We're at 1.4 average miles per hour. So that's like if you're going uphill for quite a long time. We're at 10,000 steps already today. But that's it. 4.37 miles in. You'll see that ridge there, and this beautiful rock with these flowers, and a stream running, and you'll say, this is the spot. Mr. Saving the Day about an out and back trail. Typically, you're not looking behind you, and now when you go the other way, you get to see everything.
Wow.
Going down the other way. Hey guys, beautiful wildflowers here. As we're coming down here, we get almost to the ending. You can drop off into the scenic loop. The scenic loop will take you down here by some water. And these flowers, the wildflowers, we're told were about an 8 on a scale of 10 this year. All right guys, Mr. Saving the Day, we can see the parking lot. I'm going to end everything here. Give you a shot of the Sunto. We're at 8.79 miles and 5 hours, 27 minutes taking our time. Probably an average speed of 1.4, although we tooled when we got going down on the way back here. We were really motoring, so let me hit the stop button. All right, that's it. It's official. It's saved. Thanks for coming along with us. Enjoy it if you get out here. Go past Crater Lake. I'm telling you. Just save the day out. Back at the parking lot. I can't believe we made it. And we got a parking lot. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Lucky number 7 in the parking lot today. Oh my gosh. I cried. Just save the day out.